Hi folks, this is Melvin from OptoProductions.com, and today I'll show you how to use the new Phosion 2. D16 is known for its amazing sounding emulations of famous drum computers like the 606, 808 and 909. And now they've released an updated version of their new 303 plugin. Let's dive right in with an overview of the user interface. When you load up the plugin, it's automatically set to sequencer mode. So when you press play in your DAW, or when you press the start-stop button over here, you get a sound out of it. If you press the host note tab, you can draw in a MIDI note, like C0, for example. And it will only play for the duration of that note. So you can also reset the sequence this way. But if you just want to play in some notes yourself, you need to switch the play mode to external. So now if I activate the QWERTY keyboard, in the upper left corner, you can change a different preset. And this will not only change the sound, but also the sequence. I just need to switch back to live mode for a second. You can also independently change the sound, or the sequence. But let's start with an init preset for now, so we can focus on the sound, and let's switch back to external. Okay, looking at the controls from left to right, we've got the waveform selection from square wave to saw wave, the tuning with a range of plus and minus 12 semitones. But if we enable the extended mode, we get a fine tune and a separate transpose knob, which makes it a lot easier to transpose patterns. Up next, we've got the filter cutoff and the resonance control. A filter envelope depth and a filter decay. The 303 doesn't have an amplifier envelope, only a filter envelope. And lastly, we got the accent amount. And the 303 only has two velocity levels, normal and accented. And you can change the accent levels over here. So if we play a note louder than a velocity level of 64, we get an accent. So if we look at the bottom in Ableton, now I got a regular note, and now it's accented. Even if I turn it up, the volume stays the same. Currently, the volume is also increased, but if we disable this button, we can separately control the accent volume. And if I enable it, it's linked, so this knob becomes useless. On the right half of the plugin, we get a slide time. And now might be a good time to create a sequence so we can hear what's going on. I'll change the play mode to sequence and enter in some notes. The sequencer right now just works like a regular piano roll. At the bottom we can add slides. The slide smoothly glides to the next note. So if I add it over here, maybe increase the decay. And I can also add accents per note. So So if we increase the slide time, next to the slide time, we've got the sweep amount. And you need to make sure that the button on top is disabled, otherwise you won't hear any change. The sweep amount controls the envelope curve from spiky to smooth. Depending on the resonance settings, you may prefer one over the other. So it's subtle, but you will notice it in the attack. So now it's a bit softer. And now it has more tick to it. Next to the sweep amount, we got the envelope attack time. And after that, we get a separate accent decay. So we can give accented notes even more emphasis. We already looked at the accent volume, but the last two buttons are vibrato speed and vibrato depth, which can be enabled per note as well. And if I connect some notes by adding some slides, we can hear this more clearly. Traditionally, this effect was created by alternating two notes with the slide enabled. And this vibrato effect works in a similar way, as we can still use the slide time to smooth out the effect. So to the right it's smooth, and to the left it starts to sound like two independent notes. So, that's a cool little feature. Alright, that's it for the basic controls. Still a lot more extensive than a traditional 303, but let's take a look at the built-in effects next. On the left, we've got a distortion effect, which can be activated by pressing this button. And we can choose from different distortion emulations. So, diode clipping, overdrive, and even a red pedal clone. We've got a drive knob to add distortion and a color knob to brighten up the sound or to darken it. And we even got a one knob compressor over here. And we can change the order of the compressor pre or post distortion. This compressor is really useful to even out the sound, especially if you turn up the resonance, as usually you lose some volume by doing that. So without compression, it's really dynamic, but if we reduce some, it's a lot more even. So, that's a cool feature to have. Alright. After the distortion, the signal chain continues to these five different effects. And you can even reorder these effects by clicking and dragging. I'm not going to go over all of these effects, as they are fairly common, but I really like that you can choose from different presets per effect. And you can also store presets by pressing the save button. And if you press the orange edit button, you get even more controls. We've even got separate early and late reverb controls. Usually effects on a synthesizer are more of an afterthought, but I think these effects sound pretty cool. You can also see the effect settings at the bottom, right here. Lastly, on the right, we've got a master volume knob and a bypass effect knob. It will bypass all effects, including the distortion. Alright. We've already looked at the sequencer a bit, but let's check the other features. This sequencer is pretty easy to use, much easier than the original hardware unit. But if you're used to the traditional way of sequencing, you can still do that by going to the GUI, Options, Sequencer View, and clicking Keyboard. And here is your traditional 303 sequencer. So we can choose from different steps and enable slide accent or vibrato, and we can change the octaves. But we can do the same thing in the piano roll, so let's use that for now. And here you can change the octaves on top, so let's add some random octaves. And we can also select from a huge collection of presets over here. But before I change the preset, I usually want to save the pattern. So what I usually do is to copy the pattern to another bank. If I press the copy button, select another bank, paste it here. I've got a save copy because there's no undo button in this plugin. Another way to save your pattern is to use the export function. And here you can drag a MIDI file to your DAW. And if we change to external mode, that's our pattern. So that's a very useful feature. And we can also, if we go to export again, choose drag pattern. And that's useful if you have another instance of Phocion. We can drag the pattern to the other instance. So now we have two of the same sequences with a different sound. So, that's a very useful feature as well. Okay, on the right, we've got options to change the pattern length. So we can shorten the amount of steps, and if we add a rhythm, we can actually make some polyrhythmic rhythms. So, that's useful. We also got a shuffle control. And we got a step length or gate control. We can also change the pattern speed from 1/16 to 8 notes, for example. Faster. We can even change it to dotted notes or triplets. For those really funky rhythms. Over here we've got a shift control, so we can shift the pattern to the right or to the left. And and transpose control. Lastly, at the bottom, we've got some live overrides. So this is really useful if you're playing live and you want to quickly clear out all the notes. Just hold it. Or if you want to enter notes. Or maybe if you want to add slides everywhere. These are temporary buttons. So we can add slides, or we can clear them, or accents, or vibrato. In the top right corner of the sequencer, we've got a random tab. And here we can create random patterns. We can choose a randomized preset. So for example, notes in a certain scale, like minor Dorian. And as soon as we press the draw button, we generate a new pattern. And on the left, you can choose to enable or disable certain notes. So it will only use the red notes. Or we can disable the slide control, so it doesn't add slides. So if you're happy with the accents or slides, you can lock it. And you can do the same for the octaves. And over here you can change the amount of randomization. So if I enable these, we can add less notes. Or more. We can decrease the amount of slides. Or the amount of accents. So that's a really easy way to come up with new patterns. Right, we've almost covered the whole plugin, but there's one thing left to do, and that's the arpeggiator mode. And this mode basically works in the same way as the sequencer, but this time we don't get pitches to choose from, but note indexes. Meaning if you press three notes at the same time on your keyboard and only feel the pattern on index one. I'm playing three notes right now, but I still only hear one note. So with the index, I decide which of the three notes gets played. So it's like a sequencer, but I can change the notes on the fly. So if you want to create a traditional arp, with four notes, for example, going up, you can make a pattern like this. If I press four notes, but now we've got way more flexibility because we can add slides, we can add accents, vibrato, we can even change the octaves. So that's a really powerful feature to play around with. Okay, well, there's actually one thing left in this plugin, and it's a bit hidden, but if you look in the upper right corner, we see a open button. And if you press that, we get access to the under the hood calibration settings, almost like hacking a real 303. And if you've ever worked with hardware synths, you know that no two units ever sound the same. Electronic designs all have tolerances, and right here we can tweak those settings however we like. Or we can just select a preset. So a 303 with more noisy VGAs, for example. Or we can change the settings ourselves. So we've got a filter cutoff tuning, a DC filter, and it even shows the values in millivolts or capacitance values. That's pretty cool. We can even change the tracking, so it detunes over several octaves. And we got a square pulse width shift option. And we can even change the op-amp type. And we can add some noise. So, that's a pretty fun detail. And that's it already for this video. It might seem like an intimidating plugin at first, but I have to say the interface is a lot clearer than the previous version. The only thing I miss in this plugin is that it doesn't have a sustain option, which stays true to the original, but on the Behringer TD3MO, we do have a sustain option. And I'm also missing the sub-octave mod and the FM options from the Behringer. But besides that, we do get a lot of cool effects, and I think this truly is the best sounding software alternative for that typical 303 sound. If you'd like me to make more tutorials like these, please let me know in the comments, and I'll see you soon in another video.